We got some calls, but I do want to get to this one quick thing. It's a Tucker Carlson piece, but first there's this Breitbart thing about the Oscars, because we were talking about the Oscars. And it says, Oscars host Wanda Sykes slams Florida's Don't Groom Kids bill. We're going to have a gay night. Gay, 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 gay. What the? Wanda Sykes is tripping. The Academy Awards wasted little time getting political on Sunday as the co-host Wanda Sykes slammed Florida's parental rights and education bill, announcing on live television that we're going to have a gay night. So this clip that is on Tucker Carlson interviewed the governor of Florida, and I thought it was interesting. So see if we can watch this.
Why is the hill to die on to have transgenderism injected into kindergarten classrooms or woke gender ideology injected into second grade classroom? Why is that the hill to die on? Meanwhile, if we had done a bill that prohibited talking about the abuse of Uyghurs in China, Disney would have supported that legislation because they don't want to say a word about that. So it's just an odd manifestation of their corporate values that they actually do Disney cruises, Tucker, to the nation of Dominica, which criminalizes homosexuality. So they're fine doing that and lining their pockets. They're fine lining their pockets from the CCP and all the atrocities that go on there. But it's those kindergartners in Florida that they really want to have transgenderism as part of their core curriculum in school.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing. And the reason why I love that clip is because, yeah, Disney will make this whole big thing about this and that and, you know, but then, yeah, but they won't not cruise to a place that bans homosexuality. So when it affects their money, they don't say anything.
Right.
But just to be woke or all this stuff, they're loud and all this stuff. And it got me thinking about same thing with Apple, Tim Cook. I'm a huge Steve Jobs fan. And, you know, I think what Tim Cook has done to Apple is like, it's amazing that he can come out and say all this stuff and support all these different agendas. And then no one mentions that there's slave camps making these phones in China.
Right.
You know what I mean? And so it's just, it's very convenient when they choose to use things and not. And it got me thinking about China in general, because he mentioned China in there. And then I'm thinking about Apple in China. And look at this. I saw this thing where it says China is buying up American farmland. Look at this. China is buying up American farms. Washington wants to crack down. I mean, do you think that another country could go into China and buy up any of their land?
No, that's crazy.
Do you think that would even be an acceptable concept? It's amazing. And then we're supposed to be okay with food shortages. Meanwhile, China's just buying up America. Real quick, let's just play this clip, the food shortage clip from Joe. Sleepy Joe talking about, yeah, there's going to be a food shortage.
With regard to food shortage, yes, we did talk about food shortages. And it's going to be real. The price of these sanctions is not just imposed upon Russia. It's imposed upon an awful lot of countries as well, including European countries and our country as well. And because both Russia and Ukraine have been the breadbasket of Europe in terms of wheat, for example. Just give you one example.
Amazing. I mean, is that just unreal or what?
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty baffling.
It's amazing.